Good afternoon, all. I am Kevin Seram.
And I am Anthony Trigeni Kirkwood.
We are here today on behalf of Centennial College's gallery with a wonderful live show for you.
Would you like to tell our wonderful viewers of what our topic is for the day?
You know what? I'm going to give it to you this time, TK.
Oh boy! Today, our show is about people who manage to take something that is seen into a hobby into something that is much more.
Yes. For example, meet Corrine, an artist who turned pain into passion.
My name is Corrine Haig. I am a practicing fine artist. I work with acrylic on canvas. I like to do mixed media and abstracted realism. This is a matte medium that I use, and it's an artist grade. Basically, it's like a glue, and I use that to apply the paper to the canvas to give the textural surface. I tend to reuse, so part of this whole recycle, use what you have. Whenever I get tissue in anything, I save it. It goes into my my pile of tissue. I tear it into small sheets, and I layer that onto the canvas. I have my texturized canvas. The surface has been prepped with gesso. I will just work sort of random shapes, trying to color onto the edges. No real particular order. Point is to really just get interesting layers of color. Now, pulling it into a more defined landscape. Get the viewer moving into the painting. I really started painting actively when my children were a little bit older. I had a little bit more time on building the practice, and I would spend the day with an artist that I admired and tried to learn some of their processes and put that into my sort of repertoire of things that I do. My art practice has been growing since 2009, and most actively since around 2014 when my mom passed. I spent a lot of time watching her and her process, and at that point in time I just became completely inspired to paint. I have painted really nonstop ever since.
You can check out Karen's work on her website, artofabstraction.ca.
Well, you know what? I feel like in the sake of art, we just saw some beautiful professional art. It's amateur hour here at the gallery. Let's do this. We're gonna draw each other, okay?
Fun fact, I used to actually be a really good artist until my hand stopped working and I gave up my passion.
Fun fact, I was gonna say nobody cared, but that's actually kind of tragic, so oops.
Wow.
Anyway, so let's start. I'm just gonna start with these ramen noodle Justin Timberlake.
Okay.
Circa 1990s NSYNC hair right here.
Okay, sure, fine. Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah, you know what? It's like I gave you that insult to call me 10 minutes ago.
I'm gonna give you like some chiseled, you know, some handsome Squidward. You got some like genetically defected jawline going on here and the cheekbones. Just saying, you know.
Why are you so mean to me? I thought we were friends, dude.
Love you.
I love you too, Kev. Even though you're built like that. It's got nothing to do with
me. We're gonna give
him
some chapped lips. We're gonna get some.
Can we get a zoom in on his lips? I actually don't.
The nose is broken and we're not certain. Not very certain if it's broken or not, but it's giving.
Leave my busted up nose alone for like 1 minute.
I'm gonna give you like a bulbous kind of like Christmas ornament body just because I'm really bad at drawing bodies.
I used to always do that when I was like a kid. Like I would always like, I could never draw the bodies. It'd just be like head and then just like big bowling ball bills.
Did you ever get bullied for your skinny neck?
I did just now.
And
what?
There are certain things I could say about the facial hair that I really can't say on live television or YouTube.
See,
so.
I woke up late and wanted to shave and I couldn't, so that's my own mistake. Listen, I'm trying to do your style with the goatee. I just don't have enough testosterone in my body to fulfill that.
It's okay, I'm not sure if I have that either.
That's fair enough, to be honest. That's fair enough.
Oh man, this is looking good.
I'm killing this artwork, I'm not gonna lie to you.
Okay. Let's see what else we got going on here. You know what? I'm just gonna add a couple of finishing touches.
All right. Well, here we go. This is what I drew.
Men drew a piece of cheese. Do I look like pie to
that's
you?
That's cheesecake.
Oh, come on. I feel like I worked really hard on mine. Come on now. That's pretty good.
Well, I'm sorry. I've got dessert on my mind.
Well, then you should meet Scarlett, a George Brown bakery student who has a lot of dessert on her mind. And you know what? I think she'll be much better than what we did here today.
I mean, who knows? I don't want to besmirch me.
Hi, I'm Scarlett Cadena. I'm a 21-year-old student. I go to George Brown. I'm currently in a pre-business program. I was born in Canada, but my background is Ecuadorian. The first time I became interested in baking was when I was younger. I started watching a lot of shows online on the Food Network channel. One of them was Chopped, Anna Olsen, like all those shows. I got very interested at a very young age. And from there, I wanted to try and bake whatever I could. How my parents felt about my career, they were very supportive. As long as I did something that I was passionate about and that they knew that I would continue on in the future, they were very supportive. One of the main things that was difficult when I was studying was that I studied when it was COVID. So everything that I was learning was online, and it was very hard to just get a teacher's approval and just knowing that a teacher's there to help me, because there's a lot of times that I felt like I wasn't doing something right, but I'm not gonna text my teacher every single time on Teams or something to get clarity. So that was a very hard time for sure. When I started working, it changed a lot. Being at the bakery that I am right now as a small business owner, I felt like it's given me a lot more to think about, especially on what I want to pursue in the future. It just gave me more insight on how much more depth and how much more I have to learn about before I can start doing what I want to do in the future. The person that inspired me will be my grandmother. She started baking when she came here from Ecuador. And ever since then, I was inspired. Every time I would go over to her house after school and watch her bake and help her like mix colors and just watch them pipe and write, it's including my mom. My mom helped my grandmother a lot. Both of them were such an inspiration to me, and they continue to be an inspiration to me. How I see my future in baking is hopefully I would have a business that is quite successful. It's a very main goal of mine, and I'm trying to pursue it right now, and just learning at my job that I have helped me and is continuing to help me so much.
See, I'm not much of a baker. I'm an Italian, and we like our pizza. So today, we're gonna be making the most perfect, most delicious pizza dough here seen at Centennial College.
But we're gonna twist it up. We're gonna do a little bit of a competition, okay? So we're gonna get this dough out of here. Ooh. This is some crazy, wacky, wavy dough. So we're just gonna go glomp, glomp.
Dog, oh my God, you're just getting in there.
This is show business, baby. We gotta get her out. Okay,
what we're gonna do now?
We're gonna stretch this baby out.
Okay, bet, let's go.
Okay.
You give me one end, we're gonna play tug of war real quick.
All right, let's do this real quick, okay.
Hold on, we gotta be gentle with it. We don't want it to just snap on us too quickly.
TK, this is a little much for live TV, don't you think?
Oh, I think it's just enough for live TV, Kevin. I don't know about you.
What those hands do?
What's going on here? They make magic happen in the kitchen.
Am I blushing, guys? Good thing we got hair and makeup.
I thought you didn't like me. Now you like me?
I'll get out of here. And one, two, three, and we're gonna pull.
Okay. I win. Okay. I win. Let's cook.
This is the second part of the segment. What we're going to do is we're going to try and make the best. I can't even explain to the audience. He's already going into it. So,
hey, I'm about winning. All I want to do is win and show that everyone that Kevin is the less cool host.
I'd like to let you know I'm actually half Italian. So, we're going to make it in a pizzeria. Mamma mia.
I don't think you are half Italian. I think that's just a lie.
I don't think you know my lineage. What are you? Ancestry.ca?
Yep.
Come on now.
Yep.
Do you see the technique?
Do you see my technique? Come on now, don't play with me.
I pretend I do not see it.
Okay. I'm going to pretend you're not next to me as I'm cooking this up right now.
This is giving lunchmates. This is giving, you want to
just
throw some
cheese on it. It is giving Lunchables, right?
Right?
Dude, I miss those days. That was an easier life, let me tell you.
It was, it really was back then, you know?
Dude. Were you allowed
to throw this into the oven?
Did they have color TV when that was around your time?
Oh, come on. Now I get I'm like 10 years older than you, but come on.
I wonder if low spin. Blow. I think I can do the spin thing.
Yeah. Come on.
Whoa.
I mess. Oh, I made mine so much worse as a result of that.
I feel like we should pull out some like Pillsbury Doughboy out here. You're like, woohoo!
I've never liked Pillsbury Doughboy.
Then you are not a friend of mine. That's one thing.
Oh, man.
You are not a friend of mine.
I thought we were actually getting somewhere in our friendship.
This is actually giving. This is giving pizza.
Man, all this Italian dough makes me hungry. Do you fancy actually getting a real pizza, Kevin?
You know what? Actually, no. I'm sick of pizza, I'm tired of this, and I want something healthier. So meet John Morris, a chef who went from fine dining to healthy
meals on wheels. Marriott Hotels, Delta Hotels, a lot of these chains, the National Arts Center in Ottawa, executive chef at the CN Tower. During that time, you know, I had started to eat healthier myself, and I thought, I don't want to be doing this fine dining stuff anymore. I want to kind of get into this healthy food that's helping me feel so good, and I want to help other people to get that into their diet. We started this business, JLB Kitchen. Being a chef who worked a lot and did not take care of himself very well, I had managed to get myself up to around over 300 pounds. Speaking with Jenny, my wife and partner in the business in JLB Kitchen, so I said, well, you're a nutritionist. Out of curiosity, you know, if I was one of your clients, what would you have me eating in a day? You know, what kind of stuff? Because as a chef, I knew what I liked to eat, how to make it tasty, but I had no idea proportions of what we're supposed to eat. After that, Jenny said, I would love to help you. And so she created a meal plan for me, which I found it actually very easy to follow. And in fact, on this plan, I was eating more food, just more of the right things. I lost about 70 pounds in 3 or 4 months of just eating properly. Jenny was doing these nutrition plans for people on a regular basis, and I said to her one day, I said, well, hold on a second. You know what to tell them to eat. I know how to prepare it. Let's get this on the go for people. Let's help all these people who are destined to fail in their goals. Let's help them. People fail because they end up going, you know, Uber Eats or swing by the restaurant, pick up takeout or this kind of thing. You go drive your car around the block. There's no shortage of places to find food. But how much of it is healthy? Let's take that same level of convenience that people are enjoying from fast food and such, but bring it into a healthy arena, you know? So let's get healthy food and make it convenient, accessible to people. And that's where the idea was born for JLB Kitchen. We want to be part of this movement of providing healthy choices for people. Fortunately, now we're doing it. And now it has been up and running for 1 year. In fact, tomorrow would be our 1 year anniversary of being open from this location, from our first pickup. So we're loving what we do. We're loving the fact that we can help people to achieve their goals for health and fitness. And it's not just people who are looking to lose weight that can benefit from it. It's just anybody who really, I think, is either short on time or sometimes people just plain don't like to cook. I've worked Caesar.
You know, I wish that I could do that, but I can't even make a sandwich blindfolded. Luckily, my co-host here today, Anthony, he's gonna be able to do that blindfolded because he's just so great.
I'm a natural chef. What can I say, dude?
I'm here to help you, so I'm actually gonna get some things out.
Yeah, get the bread out for me.
Get the bread out. We're gonna give you a solid foundation to go on.
Okay, but I gotta like figure out where I am. This is a bag of chips. I'm gonna bust that open.
There we go. Okay. Right hand, there's your bread. There we go.
Okay. Where's the other piece of bread?
It's right here.
Where's right here?
Bam, okay. Bam. You're good.
Okay, cool. Bye.
Okay, I'm gonna lay some things out for you, get you going, okay? We got can't tell you what they are, but
what is this?
Don't worry about it.
I'm concerned.
You might need more of that, actually.
Okay, the texture on this meat is wild.
Okay. Right there, feel it.
Yeah?
Feel it.
Okay.
Use your hand.
Okay. Ew! What is this?
Dear God, man, just go with it.
Was that a banana?
Don't think about it.
Okay.
You hear that?
No.
It's not a snake and it's not slithering, but it's...
Dog, do I have to eat whatever this concoction
feel this.
Is? What am I feeling? Is this mustard?
Oh, you smell it, eh?
Oh, okay.
Put it on your sandwich.
Okay, yes sir.
Put it. We have to prove that we can bake or we'll be kicked out of the program.
Well, I don't think we're in the baking program.
Feel
my cardigan!
It.
No!
It.
What is-
Understand. Oh my
my God, I'm having a moment. I didn't think I'd have a moment on live TV. Put it on.
Can we get security here, please?
Put it on.
Is this good? Is this a good sandwich, do you think?
Yes.
Okay. Do I have to eat this?
Yes.
Are you serious?
Take it off. I'm sorry. I'm getting aggressive.
What is this?
This is why I go to therapy.
Oh my days. Oh my days. Okay.
You know what?
If I have to eat it, you have to eat it. Yeah, I'll pluck it over.
No. Okay.
It's actually not that bad.
You know what?
It's actually not terrible.
Look at this.
Oh, that's surprisingly not terrible.
Look.
I'm actually like, okay, at first I was gagging from the bit.
No. Not on TV. Honestly, we should have live streamed that to YouTube. That was actually quite hilarious.
Dude, what about a million subs if we live streamed that on YouTube?
First of all, a million subs, that would be a lot of bread.
No, I'm talking about like subscribers, like YouTube. Do you know we actually have a very successful content creator in our crew? That is actually our homeboy Eli.
Eli?
Yeah.
You're kidding me. He's a streamer?
Yeah, me and him used to stream a little bit back in the day, you know what I mean?
He's insane.
A variety streamer too.
And I heard he actually has a great documentary coming right up.
This is what it's like to be a viewer on my streams. Okay, so for today's stream, I'm gonna do something that I don't normally do, and I'm gonna be doing the Bean Boozle Challenge.
My name is Eli, and I'm a content creator. So I'm gonna show you the journey of what it's like to be a content creator. I started doing this around February of 2021. At first, it went out really bad. Like, actually, it was terrible. I was only averaging, like, 2 viewers a stream. But over time, that increased and I started gaining a community. Around May of 2021, I uploaded 1 TikTok talking about how I was Canadian and it blew up. I'm Canadian. All of a sudden, I went to go live and I got up to 60 viewers. This was insane to me.
This was also the stream where I hit 1,000 followers. I hit 1,000! That's 2. 1! What?
Fast forward a couple months and I decided to do a 12-hour stream. I played so many games with friends and I planned it out. One of my favorite streams I've ever done. Now in 2024, I mainly just do streams with friends and play lots of games. I actually also do lots of streams alone where I literally just talk to my chat and we react to 5-minute crafts or do a tier list. And those streams are so fun. But honestly, streaming has to be my favorite way of making content. Now I'm gonna show you what it's like for me to upload TikToks. I just sit down, look at clips, and I edit them down to just make it into a TikTok. Let's go on to the YouTube portion. I work for this channel called Camp Bonkers. Hey guys, I'm Eli. Welcome to Camp Bonkers. And we have these videos where they're literally videos for kids. These videos were probably the most fun I've ever had making videos on YouTube. And I made challenge videos where I did the Bean Boozle challenge.
3, 2, 1.
No, I was gonna read that.
I swallowed it.
That's disgusting.
I'm swallowing this to prove you wrong. And working on Camp Bonkers was honestly one of like the best times of my life.
Yeah!
That's my journey. That's my gallery. Boom. That's how I make my content. I do Twitch streams, TikToks, YouTube videos, and it's a lot of fun. That's my life.
This is...
My hands are still physically disgusted from that sandwich, but we're going to discuss ourselves further. I was inspired to do Bean Boozled today.
Kevin, do you want to explain what this is all about?
Basically, we're gonna eat these beans and we are going to try to not gag because there are delicious ones and there are bad ones.
Sounds good.
We're gonna start. I'm gonna ask you a question actually. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna ask you a very intimate question about my life.
Mm-hmm.
I've known you for about 15 minutes or so. So let's, you should know this.
Okay.
What is the most traumatic thing that's ever happened to me in middle school?
The most traumatic thing that's ever happened to you in middle school?
Okay. I told you this once in passing.
You did, but I don't listen to you when you speak very often. I have to say, You probably, maybe, I don't know, you wet yourself in class.
No, I'm tragically disappointed that you didn't know this, and now our friendship level is down. Essentially, what it was this kid pulled my pants down in front of the class, and the teacher laughed.
The teacher laughed
at you? The teacher laughed.
You probably deserved it.
So eat the bean.
I have to eat a bean?
Eat the bean.
Okay. I like this one. This one looks like the one thing in Dragon Ball.
All right, fingers crossed. And what was it? What was it? Barf?
I don't know.
It was like some type of booger thing, wasn't
it? Was it the sandwich we just made?
Come on now. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna try one. You know what? I'm brave.
I'm being tortured live
this
on
one's,
TV.
This one's giving orange. Yep, that was puke.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You seem to enjoy the taste of puke. Oh, I smell in your breath. Oh my god.
Oh. I like the taste. Hold on. Give me a second. Oh. Give me another.
Dog, stop.
Give me another. Ask me a question.
Okay. How many tattoos do I have on my body?
I've never seen your naked body before, TK, so I don't know where he's going with this, but I think he's coming on to me. I'm gonna guess maybe like 1.5, you know?
One of those, one and a half?
Like a stick and poke and then a professional one.
I have seven. Seven tattoos in total. I have seven.
I guess I just gotta take another bean.
I think you just enjoy eating these.
Oh my god.
Like, I feel like you know.
Like, I just got egg. Like, rotten egg.
You know what? Hey, in the love of this, I'm gonna down some with you, okay?
Yeah. You know what? This was fun, but it's hardly a sport.
Hey, did you know that we have a sports journalism program here at Centennial? Dylan Nazareth is a sports journalist student who went to Florida for spring training, and he did a piece for his intensity of sports fans.
Well, did you know that he went to Florida and he has an amazing documentary coming up? He is going to show us that, and I'm going to interview him. I am so excited to see this documentary because he put so much energy and effort into this. I'm so excited to have us roll it.
I'm Dylan Nazareth with the Toronto Observer. And I'm here today at Port Charlotte Sports Park, where the Phillies and the Rays are engaged in a fierce matchup. But it goes beyond the field. We're here today to find out who has the best fans. So let's go. All right, I'm here with a real Philadelphian, live in the flesh. Marianne, tell me, are you a fanatic?
I am a Philly fanatic.
How much of a fanatic?
200%.
200%. Now, how long have you lived down here in Port Charlotte?
40 years.
40 years. And you're from Philly originally?
Born and raised.
What's one word you describe Philly fans as?
Crazy.
Crazy?
Passionate.
Obnoxious.
Terrible.
Arrogant.
Angry, battery throwing. Oh, no, wait. One word.
That's more than one.
We got a lot of heart.
Yeah, we have a lot
pride.
Of heart.
We got a lot of pride in Philadelphia.
That's it.
So I'm here with Lisa, and she thinks Kevin Kiermaier's blue eyes are amazing.
I do.
Do you think his blue eyes are amazing because they represent the blue color of the Rays?
Yes, but he was born with them. But he really makes them work for us.
What do you love about the Tampa Bay Rays?
I like that they're young, they're scrappy, and they always pull it out, but they play hard, they play with heart, and they represent Florida well. Now here's the thing, I grew up in New Jersey, so I was a Phillies fan.
All right, hold on. So you switched?
I've been here 40 years.
Do people here know that?
I don't know, I'm not gonna tell anybody.
I'm not gonna tell them either, but I'm seeing a lot of Phillies fans here today. A lot more Phillies fans than Rays fans.
I know.
What do you have to say to them? What's happening here? What do you want to say to the Rays fans? Fight, fight, fight.
Well, the best thing I like about the Rays is the fact that they're a small market team. By that, I mean they don't have the money that you know, the Yankees or some of those other teams can, you know, support their team with. But yet, we have a very competitive team.
All right, I'm here with Ben. He's rocking this awesome jersey. Ben, tell me a little bit about your jersey.
So it's a not actually a vintage throwback, but because they're not old enough to actually have throwbacks, they had to make their own throwback jerseys.
And what do you love about the Tampa Bay Rays?
I love the kind of the creative way they do team building. We don't have the same resources that every other team has, so we find ways to buy low, sell high, and really have been able to make amazing rosters out of roster construction and knowledge instead of actually just paying big players.
Well, no matter which fan base you think is better, I think we can all agree it was a beautiful day for some baseball at Port Charlotte Sports Park. For the Toronto Observer, I'm Dylan Nazareth. We'll see you guys next time.
We got Dylan Nazareth here from sports journalism at Centennial College. Dylan, I want to say what a great documentary you made.
Thank you so much. I mean, it's opening day for the Jays, so it's a great day to talk some baseball. I'm happy to be here.
We are amped. We are excited. I got a couple of handy-dandy questions here for you today. What was the process of getting to Florida to shoot that school production?
Yeah, I mean, we're pretty lucky. Centennial College sends our program down every year, part of their experiential learning program. And they covered all the costs. We just covered the food down there. So let's just say I ate a lot of craft dinner for about a week.
It looked like a lot of fun. And honestly, I love KD. So yeah. I feel you.
Here we go.
What was the weather like in Florida?
It was beautiful. I mean, what can you? It was Florida. What can you say? I was practically begging them not to put me on the plane back. It was, I mean, they warned us that they have had 2 days of rain in their entire history of going there.
Yeah.
And luckily we got one night. So there we go. It was sunny every day.
I am honestly jealous with this Toronto weather. It's, you know, I would rather be in Florida right now, even with the havoc. So what does spring training bring to the fans? What makes it so special?
You know, it's everything, right? Because it's the time of year, the baseball fans, they're sick of winter, they're cold up in the north, they want some baseball. And down in Florida, everyone comes together, there's all these teams, people from across the country. It's really beautiful to see. There's so much atmosphere, there's so much excitement going on in this time that baseball's coming back, you know?
All right, so are the fans as crazy as they seem, though? We gotta know.
They really are crazy. And let me say, it's the people from Philadelphia, man. They bring an energy, and whether you want to use the word crazy, which all of them seem to want to, they just bring such an energy, such an excitement. They all told me you have to go watch a game in Philadelphia sometime. Okay. I really feel it.
I can tell that you're passionate about this, aren't you?
Yeah, definitely.
I love it. We love see it here at Centennial. Fan. All right, one last question. When did the Phillies last win the World Series?
That would be 2008.
Oh, man. He's on the
it's
ball.
In the video.
You know what? Florida's hot as heck. But what's hotter is Toronto in the summertime. And what's best with summertime? A nice pastry. We got Maria's Bakery documentary coming up. Coming up real soon, we got it on lock here at Centennial.
Going back to the themes of hobbies turned into careers, here I'm going to introduce to you Evan. Here to sing us a song, his newest song, Company. Take it away for me, buddy.
All I ever wanted was your company. Now I don't know what you want from me. Tried my best to stop it, but I'm about to break. And I'm falling off this height you've given me. All I ever wanted was you wanting me. Now I don't know what you want from me. Tried my best to not, but I still contemplate how I got this f***ing high in the first. Down and broken, you left me open. Didn't know what the f*** to do. How'd you go and leave me when I just said I'm in love with you? I was hoping to see I wrote this just to say I never knew. Life could be better and I would be settled if I decide to part with you. All I ever wanted was your company. Now I don't know what you want from me. Tried my best to stop it, but I'm about to break. And I'm falling off this height you've given me. All I ever wanted was you wanting me. Now I don't know what you want from me. Tried my best to not, but I still contemplate how I got this f***ing high in the first. Honestly, when my heart locked in your gaze, I constantly miss the days where I was free. Who knew that suffering could be so emotional? Who knew how emotionless you could be to me? On my sleeve, wear my heart like decoration. On your sleeve, got my blood, nothing new. What do you see when you stop and take a second? All I can see is destruction from you. Down and broken, you left no hope and no idea what the f*** to do. How'd you go and rip my heart out just when I fell for you? Did you like the drugs? Yeah, you love me in the moment. Lucky for me, I got money just for you, yeah. you down for me like a damn helicopter. Come down for me, then you leave right after. All I ever wanted was your company. Now I don't know what you want from me. Tried my best to stop it, but I'm about to break. And I'm falling off this height you've given me. All I ever wanted was you wanting me. Now I don't know what you want from me. Tried my best to not, but I still contemplate how I got this f***ing high in the first place.
That was awesome, man.
Appreciate you.
That was awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Evan. We got it. You got you a cowboy hat. We
For
want
me?
You to get in the country one day.
For
you know, everybody be doing it.
Oh, come on. You messed
up. That was a beautiful performance.
I gotta say that was probably the best performance that we've had here at Centennial College.
And we would like to thank you so much for being here today. And we want to thank our viewers at home as well for watching the gallery. Thank you so much.
We hope that you guys had a fun time here at the gallery. We've got a show for you next week, so be sure to tune in at 2 p.m. on next Thursday.
All right, and from all of us here at Centennial College, the warmest regards. Have a great day.